So I just caught up to Blue Box, which is about 26 chapters. It's a newish Jump series, and I absolutely adore it. If you have never checked out the series before, please go do it. It's absolutely one of my favorite things running in Jump, and has the potential to be one of my favorite manga series of all time. I absolutely adore it. So I want to talk about it from the perspective of the three main characters that we know about so far, that we've seen the most of. And I'm going to start with the main character, who is one of my favorite protagonists, maybe ever? I absolutely adore him. I relate to him in so many ways, and so many of the things he does are not straightforward, and I'm gonna talk about that right now. So, the whole core of Taiki's character is that he is an insecure, awkward teenager, but he also has a lot of emotional awareness, so he understands a lot of his personal insecurities and is able to frame them and look at them in a way that is somewhat healthy. So, while he's still driven by some level of negative insecurities, he is also aware of them in a way where he can view them in some light that is positive. So let's start with his first motivation, which is to confess to his crush, Chinatsu. So Chinatsu is currently living in his house because her parents have moved abroad and she wanted to stay in Japan to compete in nationals with her basketball team. And he is in this position where obviously he doesn't want to be rejected by her because he's insecure, but he also is very aware of this awkward position she's in. That because she's living in his house, if she rejects him, then it makes things very awkward for her. And he doesn't want to do that because he wants to think about her needs as a person. And so he doesn't want to force this position onto her where she's gonna feel uncomfortable because she turned him down. I like that he cares about her as a person, enough that he's thinking about her needs and the position that she's in. So, once again, this is not straightforward. Obviously, he doesn't want to be rejected, but he also doesn't want to force anything onto her. So, it's taking a personal insecurity, but having a somewhat healthy way to look at it. So, that also flows into the second motivation he has as a character, which is that he wants to become a nationals level player. So his friends and some other people have been telling him that he's basically not in Chinatsu's quote-unquote league. So she is the star nationals level basketball player, but he is a very mediocre badminton player. And so he starts to become very, very passionate about becoming a nationals level badminton player so that he can be more on her level. But once again, it's not that straightforward. It's not as straightforward as he wants to be a nationals level badminton player so that he will be good enough for her. It is that he admires her as a person. He sees this national level athlete and he wants to have that same look on himself. He wants to think that he is also a nationals level athlete, that he's passionate, that he's driven, and that will cause him to have a more positive perspective on himself. So it's more so that he wants to be a better, more capable person, and that she has inspired him to do that. So once again, it's a bit of negative insecurity, but also positive reinforcement because she just inspires him and he wants to see those positive traits in himself. So I really, really like that level of maturity. And now we get into the last little bit of his insecurity, which is that he puts Chinatsu on a pedestal because he has two ways of looking at her, and those two ideas combine to create something that is a very unhealthy perspective. So the first is his romantic interest in her, that because he loves her, that he is attracted to her, he takes a lot of her good actions and blows them out of proportion because he sees her with rose-tinted glasses. To him, she is just the most empathetic, kind, and incredible person. But because he also admires her as an athlete, those two perspectives merge. Now, as an athlete, she is on a different level than him. She is this badminton, or she is this basketball nationals level player, and she is above him as a person. Now, because he views her as above him, as an athlete, that combines with his romantic feelings for her. So it's not just that she is above him as an athlete, it's also that she's above him as a person, and that he will take every action she does and blow it out of proportion because of this perspective. So the best chapter that conveys this idea is the chapter where he accidentally takes her gym clothes, and he decides he has to go bring them back to her. So she decides to change in front of him, and she basically just puts her suit on top of her school clothes or whatever. It's not anything super awkward. But she does not feel flustered doing that in front of him, and obviously he can't watch. but he starts thinking really, really hard about the significance of this very small interaction, and he starts to think that if she's not flustered to change in front of him, even though it's not super awkward, then it must be because she does not view him as a man, that she doesn't care to show this thing that he thinks is embarrassing, because she clearly does not view him as someone to be flustered around. And he feeds that into his insecurity and that he is just not manly enough. But at the end of that chapter, we see that his perspective was wrong the whole time, because she tells him his shirt is inside out. And so he takes off his shirt to put it on right. And he can see that she's actually flustered when that happens. And he realizes that this whole time that he had taken this idea out of proportion, that he has taken this interaction and blown it up to the point where he has viewed himself in this negative light when he never needed to. So he realizes after that interaction that Chinatsu is actually just a normal person. And part of his little arc in this manga right now is that he's gonna start not just looking at her as a normal person and stop worrying that, you know, she's above him, quote unquote, because she's a national level player, and realize that she is just a person like him and that he should treat her normally and stop taking everything she does and having it feed into his insecurities. So I really, really like that. But once again, the most interesting part of his character is nothing is just purely negative. It's not that his drive to be a badminton player is a negative thing. It is that there is a level of insecurity, but there is a level of he wants to be a better person. So everything is a combination of something good and something bad. And that is a very, very interesting approach that is very, very good. Okay, so now moving on to Chinatsu, who I decided to do a re-recording for because I reread chapter 26 and I realized that Chinatsu is a lot like Taiki. Now, she doesn't have a lot of the same issues that he does when it comes to wanting to confess to her, but an important part of Taiki's arc is realizing that Chinatsu is a normal person, but she's a normal person in a way that makes him relate to her a lot, where she has a lot of the same insecurities that he does. So in chapter 26, he talks about how he didn't write down that a goal for him was to get to nationals because for him it felt like too lofty of a goal. And she talks about how she feels the same way about her nationals approach for basketball, that she has these same insecurities and she feels like he's a comrade of sorts, that he understands where she's coming from in that regard. And it's nice. It's nice in a lot of ways. We're coming to understand that as much as she is this incredible person, that she's passionate, she's driven, and she's incredibly skilled, she can still feel a lot of the same things that Taiki feels. And it just makes her a really wonderful and endearing character because she isn't this perfect person that he puts on a pedestal. She is a lot like him. And I think that that's good. That's grounds for their potential relationship, which I imagine will definitely happen because it was in the one shot. Chinatsu is very good. She is passionate, she's endearing, she's wonderful. She's also becoming a lot more competitive for Taiki's attention. Now, part of that could be that she has romantic feelings developing, but another thing is because she looks at Hina and how close she is with Taiki, and I guess she kind of wants that for herself, where she wants to have these closer connections with Taiki. Part of it might just be because they're living in the same house and she wants to get closer to him so she's more comfortable in that environment, but a part of it could just be that she is starting to develop these subconscious romantic feelings, because in one chapter, Hina stole some of Taiki's food. Chinatsu actually outright said that she was a little bit jealous, so it seems like getting closer to Taiki is an important goal to her in terms of her relationship with him and what she wants out of that relationship. So I'm very excited to learn a little bit more about her because I don't know too much about her, but from what we have seen, I really do like her character. She's very endearing and wonderful. So the final character I want to talk about is Hina, who is a very interesting character who might also have romantic feelings for the main character, but it hasn't been made explicitly clear yet. So she is also a nationals level player, and she has been kind of feeding into Taiki's insecurities, where she's been telling him like, oh, like she's out of your league, and she thinks this too. Like she looks at Chinatsu and tries to obviously prop up Taiki in Chinatsu's mind, as if Chinatsu really is like this incredible person who can only date another incredible person or whatever. But Chinatsu has not been helpful in Taiki's perspective of Chinatsu. Or Hina has not been helpful in Taiki's perspective of Chinatsu. Now, Hina has, in my opinion, I'm not sure if it's romantic, but I think that Hinata, or Hina, is very dependent on Taiki. Hina comes from an environment where there is a lot of pressure on her to succeed. She is a dancer, she's a gymnast, and because of that, if she fails, it's her fault. If she succeeds, it's her merit, or whatever. And the only person who does not put pressure on her is Taiki. And because of that, she doesn't want to lose this dependent relationship in her life where she can turn to this person who doesn't put expectation on her. Now, this becomes a little frustrating for her because when Taiki starts liking Chinatsu and wanting to confess to her, she realizes that maybe it might be better for her to distance herself from him, but that becomes harder for her to do because of how much she needs him in her life so that she has someone who's not going to put expectation on her, who's not going to put pressure on her, who can be there for her as a friend. So it's this very interesting dynamic. Once again, I don't know if it's explicitly romantic, but there's definitely a desire to keep this relationship in her life and not want to distance from him, even though she views that maybe that's best for him in that situation. But of course, she ends up being wrong because he still wants to be close to her and friends with her. So that's pretty much all I have to say about this manga so far. I really, really love it. I might make some more future videos on it. Definitely when the series is done, I'll have a lot to say about it. So if you enjoyed this video, feel free to like and subscribe and check out my main channel, Furphy vs. Anime, for more in-depth analysis videos rather than just rambling into the camera. Thank you, and I'll see you all next time.